U.S. Federal Court of Appeals here in Washington, D.C. heard arguments today in a case challenging the force feeding of Guantanamo Bay detainees. Now, three detainees have challenged their force feeding and have asked the court to put an end to it. The issue at hand today was whether or not the court even has jurisdiction to do that, though. Because earlier this year, a U.S. District Judge ruled that while force feeding is painful and humiliating, the courts don't have the power to stop it at Guantanamo Bay. Now, it's that decision that's being challenged today, right here. And we'll have to see if this federal appeals court gives power to the courts to put an end to force feeding procedures at Guantanamo. Now, at the prison, 16 hunger strikers are still being force fed on a daily basis. Now, this is a procedure that's been deemed unethical and even torturous by the World Medical Association and by the United Nations. After today's hearing, a number of organizations gathered in front of the courthouse to protest the continued use of force feeding.
Close Guantanamo now! Close Guantanamo now!
It was there that activist Andres Conteras, who's been on a hunger strike for more than 100 days drinking only water, underwent a force feeding procedure himself.
Force feeding is being done to prevent prisoners who would rather die in Guantanamo than to live in the limbo of what they are living, not knowing when they will be free, but also the constant psychological and physical torture that they are living every single day.
Then the force feeding began. Conteras described the pain.
When the tube has gone in, at times it has blocked my capacity to breathe. It has felt like constant agony, and it is fire in your throat.
As you saw, it's absolutely gruesome, and this happens out of sight in Guantanamo to the men who are force-fed. So the hope is that bringing visibility to the gruesomeness of enteral feeding will shock the conscience and make Americans troubled by what the government's doing.
I cannot not stop, and so I have gone in front of the White House. Why? Because we need to reveal to the light of day what is the torture that is happening in the shadows.
Now, we'll have to wait some time, perhaps months, before we hear the appeals court's decision. But activists here are confident that actions like this today and the strikes still underway at Guantanamo are working, and they're raising public awareness and political will to do something about a prison that just can't seem to be closed and a hunger strike that just won't go away. In Washington, Sam Sachs, RT.